Hi students, this is KL Naidu. Welcome back to our channel. So students, in previous session I have discussed about galvanic cells and nanocyst equation in electrochemistry. So in this session I am going to discuss about Faraday's laws. Okay, Randy? These laws are very important for IP examination and objective exams also. So there are two Faraday's laws. So first one is first law for Faraday and second law. Okay, so first law. The Faraday first law tells about the mass of the substance deposited at electrodes is directly proportional to quantity of electricity. That means, let us observe Daniell cell. In Daniell cell, two half cells are there. First cell is filled with zinc sulfate solution, and second cell is filled with copper sulfate solution. In this cell, copper rod is dipped into it. In this cell, zinc rod is dipped into it. So it is acts as an anode and it is acts as a cathode. Okay. During the electrolysis, electrons transfers from zinc electrode to copper electrode. Okay, in copper electrode, Cu2 plus copper ions converted into copper metal. So this metal is deposited at copper electrode. The mass of the copper deposited at cathode is directly proportional to the quantity of electricity is passed through the electrodes. Okay, that is this one. Mass of the substance deposited at cathode is directly proportional to quantity of electricity is passed through electrodes. Okay, that is this one. But the statement is, the amount of the substance deposited at electrode during the electrolysis of an electrolyte is directly proportional to the quantity of electricity is passed through it. Okay, so that is indicated by M is directly proportional to Q. Okay, where M equal to mass of the substance and Q equal to quantity of electricity. Okay guys, since M equal to small e into Q, where small e equal to electrochemical equivalent, that is indicated by capital E by capital F. Capital E equal to equivalent weight, and F equal to Faraday, equal to 96,500 coulombs. Okay, next one, Q equal to quantity of electricity, that means it is a product of current into time. So product of, that means the quantity of electricity equal to current into time. Okay guys, so these two values are substituted in this reaction, then M equal to capital E by F into C into T. Okay, and capital E equal to weight by valence. That means atomic weight. In this case, atomic weight by valence. Valence means it is indicated by N. Okay. Atomic weight by valency into Ct by F. It is the final formula of M. One problem is there. Okay, after completion of second law, I will explain. Okay, you don't worry. Next one is second law. Second law explains about the mass of the substances deposited at electrodes, is directly proportional to equivalent weights of electrolytes. That means ఇక్కడ మాస్ అనేది ఏ మెటల్ యొక్క మాస్ తీసుకుంటామో దాని యొక్క ఈక్వివలెంట్ వెయిట్ కి డైరెక్ట్లీ ప్రపోర్షనల్ గా ఉంటుంది. సపోజ్ లెట్ అస్ అబ్జర్వ్ టు సెల్స్. ఫస్ట్ సెల్ కంటైన్స్ KgNO3 సొల్యూషన్, సెకండ్ సెల్ కంటైన్స్ కాపర్ సల్ఫేట్ సొల్యూషన్. ఓకే, దీస్ టూ సెల్స్ ఆర్ కనెక్టెడ్ ఇన్ సిరీస్ అండ్ connected in battery. These two cells are connected in series. Okay, then the same quantity of electricity is passed through these two cells. Some amount of silver is deposited at cathode. At the same time, some amount of copper is deposited at cathode. Okay, the deposited amount of silver and deposited amount of copper depends on the equivalent weight of silver and copper. Okay guys, what is the statement? When the same quantity of electricity is passed through different electrolytes connected in series, the weight of the substances deposited at electrodes are directly proportional to their equivalent weights. E equal to equivalent weights, where m equal to mass of the substances or weight of the substances deposited. That is m. Okay guys, it is second law of thermodynamics. In this situation, mass of silver by mass of copper equal to equivalent weight of silver by equivalent weight of copper. Okay, next, or m1 by m2 equal to e1 by e2. It is the final equation. Okay guys, it is the second law of Faraday. Okay students, first law మీద ప్రాబ్లం చూద్దామండి. A solution of CuSO4 is electrolyzed for 10 minutes with a current 1.5 amperes. What is the mass of copper deposited at the cathode? So 1.5 amperes current 10 minutes pass చేస్తే copper sulfate solution ఉండే copper ఎంత mass ఉండే copper deposit అవుతుంది at cathode అని వాడు క్వశ్చన్ అడుగుతున్నాడండి. సో సింపుల్ గా ఆల్రెడీ మనం ఫస్ట్ లా ఆఫ్ ఫారడే లో మనకి ఆల్రెడీ ఒక ఫార్ములా వచ్చింది కదా, అటామిక్ వెయిట్ బై వాలెన్సీ, కరెంట్ ఇంటూ టైం బై ఓకే ఫారడే. ఓకే, సో సొల్యూషన్ ఓకే, టైం ఈక్వల్ టు 10 మినిట్స్ ఈక్వల్ టు 10 × 60 600 సెకండ్స్. ఓకే, నెక్స్ట్ కరెంట్ సి ఈక్వల్ టు 1.5 ఆంపియర్స్. ఓకే, నెక్స్ట్ weight of atomic weight of copper equal to 63, valence equal to 2. Valence means Cu2+ + 2 electrons gives rise to Cu. So in this reaction 2 electrons are involved, so valence is 2. Okay, next one is F equal to, we know that 96,500 coulombs. So therefore, what is the formula? Mass equal to, okay, atomic weight by valency. Atomic weight by valency into Ct by F. Okay, atomic valency equal to atomic weight equal to 63 by valency equal to 2. Into C equal to 1.5 into T equal to time equal to 600 seconds by F equal to 96,500. Okay students, so simplify chesthe manaki 0.297 grams vastundandi, 0.297 grams. It is very 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 ఇంపార్టెంట్ ప్రాబ్లం అండి. ఇది మనకు 4 మార్క్స్ అడగొచ్చు. two marks lo enna adagochu. Okay students, idu manike entante Faraday first law and second law. So ee video meeku nachithe like cheyandi, share cheyandi, alage man channel subscribe chesukokapothe subscribe chesukondi, bell icon ni click cheyandi, mee friends ki refer cheyandi. Thank you for watching.